In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This miracle of feeding the multitude, we have it many times during the Coptic calendar. Every Coptic month become 5 Sundays. On the 5th Sunday, that is extra Sunday of the month, we read the same miracle, which means it is the miracle of blessing. Even every day in midnight praise, we read the gospel of the feeding of the multitude to say, thank you, Lord, for feeding us every day. So it is a miracle of blessing. No matter how little we have, no matter how weak we are, but with the blessing of God, it would be too much. As a matter of fact, it will never end. It will never end. Our Lord Jesus Christ asked the disciples, went to the Lord saying to him, dismiss people because they have no food here, and they are going to faint if we leave them here. Can you imagine that the Lord was talking to the multitude for how long? It was 3 days. 3 days. 3 days people are sitting there hearing the word of God and could not leave him. And this is what we want to understand. Does the word of God really take a place in our daily life? People, when he heard the Lord talking, they sat and they forgot themselves. They forgot their work, they forgot their homes, they forgot everything and stayed to hear him. Does the word of God has got the same place for us? Do we really anxious and keen and very cautious to hear the Lord every day? This is what we need to do. When the Lord finished talking, as we all, when we come to the church, we hear the word of God, yes, on the gospel and readings. Then we go to the altar and unite with the word of God. So they heard the word of God, and then the Lord said to the disciples, when they told him, dismiss them because they haven't got much food left, he said, you give them to eat. Here, the Lord wanted to, the Bible tells us, he wanted to test their faith. Test their faith. Can you give them to eat? Alulu, where from? Where from? Philip said to him, 200 denarii wouldn't be enough to get even little bread for for each one. Andrew said to him, there is a boy, have got two fish, and in Greek it is psarion, which is the small, very thin fish, with five loaves of bread. But what is this for all this multitude? But the Lord said to them, okay, let them all sit 50 by 50. And here, the Lord asked the boy to come and give him the two fish and the five loaves. And the Lord took the two fish and five loaves, blessed them, broke the bread and gave it to the disciples, and the disciples were surprised that these two fish and five loaves became enough for not only the 5,000s, because they are 5,000s without children and women, maybe 15 to 20,000s. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? It simply means the two fish and five loaves became unlimited, unfinished. And this is exactly what we do, or we still do, up till now, all over the whole world, with the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Since the Lord went to the Last Supper and took the bread and broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, this is my body, this is my blood, it never finished. It hasn't been finished. And up till now, in every liturgy, we are dissecting the time to go to the Last Supper, to get the same body and the same blood from the hands of the Lord. It will never finish. It is unlimited. So after the Lord has blessed and gave the disciple, and the disciples gave to people, which is the priesthood, I wanted you all to understand. The Lord said to them, give them to eat. But then the Lord is the one who gave the disciples what they give to the people, which simply means the Lord wants us to understand the blessing of giving. The blessing of giving. Those who give will be given. Those who donate, they will have much more. It says in the Bible, no one have left anything for the sake of the Lord, except that he will have 100-fold here, plus heavenly kingdom. This is the blessing of giving as well. And In this miracle, the Lord actually have used everyone. He used the little boy. He used the disciples to give people to eat. He used the people themselves, he said, 50-50. They were arranging themselves to sit for 50-50. He used even the baskets. The baskets are, you know, they brought some sick people who couldn't really walk, and they didn't at that time have the wheelchairs. So they carried the sick people in baskets. So he healed the sick and used their baskets to feed the multitude, used everything. And this is one of the wonderful organization that the Lord wanted to teach all of us, that we all share in serving Him and serving each other. And the Lord was teaching the disciples faith. So what is faith? How can we have that faith? That faith cannot be of benefit for all of us unless we hold on His promises. You said, Lord, so it will happen. So hold on God's promises. And as well, ask. Pray. So His promises, your prayers, and as well, while you are praying, praise the Lord. Admit that He can do everything. He is the one who said, what is impossible for man is possible for God. Don't say anything, it is impossible. Yes, many things are impossible for us, but possible for God. The one who blessed the 2 fish and 5 loaves can bless you, can make your life different. But to believe. When the Lord said to them, you give them to eat, they said, we can't. But the Lord wanted every one of us to say to Him, yes, I can, Lord, though I don't have any, but I can, according to your promise, according to your word, and with your blessing. One day the Lord said to Saint Peter, come, step out of your boat and come walk on the water. St. Peter stepped out of the boat and walked on the water. Can it happen to us? Yes, with faith, with prayer, with praise, and with purity as well, which means unless I am pure in heart, I wouldn't be able to see God. I wouldn't be able to connect with God. So purity and repentance is the key for us to connect with God. It's the key for us, for God to answer our prayers and to be glorified in our lives. Our sins can separate us from God. Sin is not a problem for God because He carried all our sins. But when sin separates us and takes us from the Lord, away from the Lord, then it is a big problem. So faith, to be active in our life, we have to hold on His promises, to pray and ask, to praise Him, to be pure, and as well to be positive. To be positive. Not to think life is finished. I am having a big problem, life is dark. No, no, be positive. You have faith. Then your faith will put the darkness behind, will enlighten your life. So in this miracle, it is a miracle of blessing. It is a miracle, it is a sacramental miracle that makes us to be always living in it as we come to have the Holy Communion. We are still living in this miracle up till the end of days. It is a miracle of giving. It is a miracle of sharing all together, and it is a miracle of faith that we all need to live it. May our Lord give us all to live in this miracle every day with the Lord, in every aspect in our lives. Glory to God forever. Amen.